click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in the previous lecture we have got to know about how the reaction of alkyl halide and along with that of that is aqueous KOH as well as moist Ag2O solution takes place. And now we are going to talk about the next chemical property of the alkyl halide, that is what is the reaction of alkyl halide with that of that is potassium cyanide, alcoholic potassium cyanide along with that of alcoholic AgCN, that is silver cyanide. So what is the reaction behind that one? Let us talk about it. So unlike the previous one, that is unlike the reaction between that is an alcohol along with that of that is aqueous KOH solution as well as moist Ag2O or silver oxide. So in both the cases we have obtained the alcohol, but in this case it is not the same. Here we are using different kind of reagent. That is, suppose what if we are reacting it with an alkyl with that of that is KCN solution, and what if when an alkyl is being treated with that of alcoholic AgCN solution. So among this, one of this will give you an alkyl cyanide, while the other one will give you an alkyl isocyanide. So that is the thing that we are going to talk about, and this gives us two different kind of products. And now let us elaborate this kind of reaction, and let us talk about the first one, that is what is the action of that is alcoholic KCN solution on alkyl halide. So talking about the first reaction, that is what is the reaction of alkyl halide with that of that is alcoholic potassium cyanide. So let us understand the general reaction first, and then on we'll move on with the that is examples. So talking about the general reaction, it is very easy to understand. That is, whenever an alkyl halide that is being represented by Rx, so therefore this is alkyl halide. So once it has been treated with alcoholic KCN solution, this is what it has been represented, or alcoholic potassium cyanide. So again, this reaction is basically a substitution reaction, in which we could say that this K, that is this potassium, along with that of this halogen atom, that would be removed in the form of that is KCN. So this K along with this X, it would be removed in the form of that is KX, and the only thing that would be removed that would be left out is basically this alkyl group and this cyanide group. So therefore it could be written as RCN, or basically it is known as alkyl cyanide. And this is what we have. So this is the reaction that we have, and let us understand the example behind that one. So therefore this is basically a substitution reaction that takes place over here, and let us move on with the example of this one. So the common example that I am going to talk about is, whenever that is, suppose if I take methyl bromide. So whenever the methyl bromide is being treated with that as alcoholic KCN solution, so this reaction will proceed in such a manner that this potassium along with that of this bromine atom, that would be removed in the form of that is KBr salt, or basically known as potassium bromide salt. And the only thing that would be left out is basically this alkyl group along with that of this CN. So therefore this could be given as that is CH3CN. So according to the common name, the name of this one could be given as that is methyl cyanide. So but talking about that is the IUPC name, because in this case, because as we could see that two carbon atoms are being present over here, so therefore this could be called as that is ethane nitrile. So therefore the name, according to the IUPC name, the name is ethane nitrile, or else in terms of common name it would be called as methyl cyanide. So this is the reaction that we get over here, and so we get a cyanide, basically we get an alkyl cyanide whenever an alkyl halide is being treated with that of an alcoholic that is potassium cyanide solution. So this is what we have got over here, and we could give another example also. So let me talk about the another example when we'll do the question related to this one. And now let us move on to the next one, that is what is the action of that is alcoholic that is AgCN solution on alkyl halide. So this reaction, that is the reaction of alkyl halide with that of, that is silver cyanide, alcoholic silver cyanide, is comparatively different with that of the previous one. That is what we have talked about, the reaction of alkyl halide with that of, that is potassium cyanide. So the reaction can be given in the form of the general reaction that I am talking about. So suppose if I take an alkyl halide, that is Rx, along with that of, that is alcoholic silver cyanide, suppose over here I have mentioned over here. So in this case, basically the byproduct that would be removed as AgX. So that is very easy to understand. That is, again, it is a kind of a substitution reaction that takes place over here. But the product that we have will get over here, it is not an alkyl cyanide. It will be actually an alkyl isocyanide, and that could be represented as RnC. Yes, this is alkyl isocyanide. So this is the difference between the reaction of alkyl halide with that of, that is KCN solution and AgCN solution. So now let us understand the example of it. For example, if I take, suppose that is a common example that I would take over here as, suppose CH3Cl along with that of, that is AgCN, and that also alcoholic AgCN solution, and if I'm hitting it, suppose. So now the byproduct that would be removed is basically AgCl or silver chloride salt. But the product that we could obtain over here is, the product would be basically CH3 along with that of, that is, we could represent it with NC, that is alkyl isocyanide, and in this case basically the common name it would be basically methyl isocyanide. But talking about the IUPC name, but the IUPC name of this one could be given as, that is, so this group, according to the IUPC name, can be given as carbyl amino, and so therefore this is carbyl amino while this is methane, so therefore the name of this one could be given as so this is what we have mentioned over here, and that's it. So this is basically the example that we have mentioned over here. So therefore we have got to know that is the two different reactions that we could get over here, and now let us move on to the next one, that is let us do a few questions related to this one. So talking about the first question, that is, what is the action of that is alcoholic potassium cyanide on, that is, 2-chloropropane? So that could be given as, because here we have to do the reaction with that of, that is 2-chloropropane along with that of, that is alcoholic potassium cyanide. So it is very easy to draw the structure for that one, that is CH3CH, here it is CH3, and here it is chloroprene. So therefore this is 2-chloropropane, and we have to react it with that of, that is alcoholic potassium cyanide, so that could be given as, that is KCN, and that also alcoholic. So therefore this kind of reaction, it will give us a basically a substitution reaction. Therefore this potassium along with that of this Cl atom, that would be removed as, that is KCl salt or potassium chloride, and the only thing that would be left out is basically, we could write it over here as CH3 CH, here it is CH3, and this is C double bond N. But talking about the IUPC name, so the IUPC name is very easy to understand, and the thing is, according to the common name, the name of this one would be, because this is isopropyl chloride, while this one could be called as isopropyl cyanide. But we have to talk about the IUPC name. So the IUPC name should consist of the functional group also. So therefore, in this case, the functional group is basically the cyanide group. So therefore, this is the carbon number 1, 2 and 3. Obviously, we could give it as carbon number 1, 2 and 3. So the second carbon, basically the methyl group is present. So therefore, we could call, according to the IUPC name, the name of this one could be given as, that is 2-methyl. And the total number of carbon that has been present in a straight chain, except the substituent, here is basically 1, 2, 3, basically propane. And because here it is a cyanide group, so therefore the name of this one would be 2-methyl propane nitrile. So this is what we have got over here. So this is the first question that I was talking about, and now let us move on to the next question. So the next question is, what is the action of that is alcoholic silver cyanide on ethyl chloride? So it is very easy to understand. That is, what we have to do is we have to react the ethyl chloride with that of the alcoholic silver cyanide. So therefore, ethyl chloride can be represented as that is C2H5Cn. Along with that of, we have to react it with that is alcoholic silver cyanide, that is AgCN. Again, a substitution reaction that could take place over here in such a manner that is this silver atom along with that of this Cl atom that would be removed as AgCl salt or silver chloride salt. And the only thing that we could get over here is not cyanide, is actually isocyanide. So therefore, we could get it over here as C2H5. Instead of CN, we will write NC. So we see this is basically ethyl isocyanate that we have obtained over here. But talking about the IUPAC name, even the IUPAC name is very important for us to understand. So therefore, this is basically a carbyl amino group. So therefore, the name is carbyl amino, and this is basically ethane. So therefore, the name is basically carbyl amino ethane. So this is what we have got over here. So that's it. So this were the reactions of the alkyl with that of the respective, that is alcoholic casein solution as well as alcoholic AgCN solution. So as to obtain basically an alkyl cyanide as well as an alkyl isocyanide. So this is what I was talking about. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood this video very clearly, and we'll share this video with the friends too. So till yet, don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.